Hey YouTube, so I am actually on the same exact drive as I was when I did this trip video on the 2012 Chevrolet Impala, and I want to go ahead and share with you guys whether or not this 2015 Hyundai Elantra SE model is a good road trip car. Now, besides the very good gas mileage on this vehicle, there are a few things that make this car sort of enjoyable, and there are a few things that make it sort of not enjoyable, and I'll go ahead and share with those with you guys as we go along. So the first thing about this car that's actually enjoyable is the fact that it's still relatively easy to pick up speed in this thing. When it comes to passing, yes, you will have to downshift a couple gears, but it's not loud. It doesn't feel like the car is straining itself out. And although I have a spare tire now, luggage, two tool sets, and a few Christmas presents, this car still speeds up rather nicely, and it holds its own. It does a really good job. I've been getting around 37.5 on the gas mileage. However, that's also traveling over 80 miles an hour for most of it, because I am on the Interstate 15 where everybody speeds like a maniac, and the lowest you should be going is around 75 miles an hour. So, with that being said, this car does handle relatively well, and the gas mileage on it is good. It's a peppy engine. And it's really got a good amount of passing power for the little 1.8 liter four-cylinder engine. It actually does a really good job. And shifts are still relatively smooth. I noticed that when I drove the Nissan, the Chevy, and even my Honda, when I actually kept going for a while, the shifts became harder. This car specifically does not have that happen. In fact, the shifts maintain their smoothness throughout the entire drive, no matter how hard you're accelerating. And Hyundai did a really good job to make this car seem more expensive than it really is. And I mean, I don't mean to make that sound like an insult, but there are cheap things in this vehicle. However, the way it drives very luxurious for a compact / mid-size car. Now, the things that make it kind of annoying. Now, although this car feels very planted and very direct, unfortunately, with this power steering, it can get a little off direction, and this is what I mean. Basically, the steering stiffens up as you're going faster. The electric power steering, Hyundai did this, obviously, you know, give you more control of the vehicle, have it go more in a straight line. And although that is good, that also comes with a setback, because when the crown of the road is constantly changing to the right and to the left, your car will drift. And what happens is that your steering now has to cross a threshold to get your car back on track, and you as a driver will jerk the wheel a little bit more than it should be jerked, essentially, and you will end up going the other way. Now, it's not exactly, you know, the most annoying thing, but again, you know, you have to keep in mind that this is a very light vehicle. So when you do that, the car, with its very, very direct directionality, will ultimately veer off more than it should. However, it's not uncomfortable. It's really easy to get used to. But with the crown of the road constantly changing, you definitely want a little bit lighter steering. So what I ended up doing was, is on the way here, I ended up putting it in comfort mode. And it helped a little bit, but again, your steering has to cross that threshold to actually get power. So you will end up moving the wheel a little bit more and correcting the car. But, you know, don't think your alignment is off, because ultimately when I got onto a straight-lined road with no crown, this car was dead center. So it definitely is the crown of the road when it comes to this. But as you can see, it actually drives really nicely. And again, I'm getting 37.5 miles per gallon. And, you know, that's with me not driving very economical. When I actually was on the way to California, I was doing a good 70, 75 the whole way. And I easily got 41 miles per gallon. So this car definitely, Hyundai improved it a lot. And because I remember the 2012 and 13 models, and even the 2011s, holy crap, I could not cross like 34 miles per gallon. So Hyundai did do something to make these engines more efficient. Now, one thing also is I love Hyundai's warranty, because literally right before I was about to get on the freeway, I went to go get gas, and I popped the gas cap says tighten until one click. So the click ended up being a little too loud on this time around, and I actually broke the little plastic part that clicks. So I had to go to Hyundai, and it gave me a free gas cap. So I was very happy. Warranties are freaking bomb. But yeah, as you can see, doing a steady 80 miles an hour, 37.5 miles per gallon. And like I said, this car is a really good trip car. It's just, be prepared to correct it a little bit, but with the gas mileage, with the acceleration of the car, and its smoothness even at high speeds, you should have no issues taking this on a trip. I actually found this to be very enjoyable. even more so enjoyable than the Chevrolet Impala. Even though that one, I will admit, is a better trip car, again, it's so floaty that your passengers may get a little car sick. So keep that in mind, but overall, this is a very stiff ride, and again, like I said, it's a great driving car. It feels very sturdy, very durable, and it also feels just rather... it's not complacent. That's what I like. It's not a lazy vehicle. It's got directionality, it's got the pep, and, you know, it responds well to the driver's commands. So kudos to Hyundai for building a good car, I think, in my opinion. Hopefully it will last. All right, you guys, have a good one.